I'd like to welcome everybody here today for this exciting event, which has been a long time coming. The BHA has been working with the local tenant organization, the local elected officials, the local neighborhood groups for several years to reach this day, and we're delighted to be here the beginning of what we know will be a complete transformation of the entire Orient Heights public housing development, which we know will certainly improve the quality of the lives of the residents that live here, but we're hoping certainly that it will improve the entire neighborhood as well, the entire Orient Heights and East Boston neighborhood. So we're delighted to be here. Our first speaker, because we have several speakers before we get to the symbolic groundbreaking or demolition, because one of the items that this project includes is complete demolition of the existing buildings, which is something that we certainly wanted and something that the public housing residents wanted and the surrounding neighborhood wanted as well, so that we literally start from scratch with the architecture and make buildings that are more suitable and fit better into the Orient Heights neighborhood. So without any further ado, I am delighted to introduce our first speaker, someone who I have been very proud to serve as his administrator of the Boston Housing Authority for 3 years, someone who has, over the past 3 years, been a staunch neighborhood supporter and a staunch supporter of public housing in the city of Boston. Please, a warm welcome for our mayor, Marty Walsh. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I want to, I think everyone in this room is listed on the back of this PT here.
You're right.
Just about. So, you know, to put a project like this together, a development like this together, it takes a lot of people. And I want to thank all the people. And if I don't mention you, it doesn't mean that we don't love you. I don't love you. It's just that we'll be here for 3 days. And I truly do want to thank everyone who had something to do with putting today together. But most importantly, I want to thank Billy McGonigal. Billy is, he has just done an incredible job. Before I was the mayor, I was a state representative and I was the head of the building trades. And I had a chance to work with Billy on a couple things. One was a program called Building Pathways, which created a pre-apprentice program to give young kids of color the opportunity to get into the building trades. And that came out of the Old Colony Housing Development, PLA. And from that time, Billy has been a strong partner there and working on trying to redevelop a lot of the housing authority, a lot of the housing developments we have in the city of Boston. And I, you know, it's great to see that in our short time together, 3 years together, we have either something happening everywhere or almost something happening everywhere. And we're going to continue to do that because it's important that the residents of the developments live in a top-notch, first-class quality housing development. And that's what we're doing here today. And I want to thank a bunch of other people. I want to thank City Council Salamatina, who I know that who we talk about this a lot, and he talks about Orient Heights and we need to do something here, and Sal's been great, a partner, in being able to work on coordinating the money and getting the money together. Your state representative, Adrian Madaro, you know, Adrian spent time as an aide at the State House and became the state representative and you know, just done an incredible job of working to make sure that the district and particularly this development takes off. And I want to thank you. Your new state senator, Joe Boncori, who's here. You know, this project was underway moving forward when Joe came in, and the first thing Joe said is, what can I do? How can I help and move forward? And thank you, Joe. When I was campaigning for mayor 3 years ago, we walked this neighborhood with Joe Ruggiero, and we walked the streets, and we talked about, we looked out, and Joe said, you know, this is something here that if we could fix this, you know, there was you know, dumpsters overflowing and a lot of things going on, and that wasn't a slap at the BHA. It was just that there was a lot of people there and we need to do something. And Joe said, if you ever do something here during your tenure as mayor, that'd be important. And today, Joe, we're here today doing it. So thank you for that walk. Um, our partners at the state, Crystal Cornegay, who's an incredible partner at the state. We were just talking about our past lives and how we have the opportunity now in our new lives to be able to do great things. And this is one of the things that we can do. So thank you, Crystal. Eva Ehrlich and the whole team at Trinity. I see Patrick here. Thank you so much for your work. Where's Eva? Oh, right here. Before Eva got on the stage, she was out there coordinating things. She was talking to her dad, saying, "Dad, you sit down there. You're going to be all set in this job." I want to thank Eva for her great work. Al Caldarelli in the East Boston Community Development Corporation. Thank you, Al. And I'll say this, the most important person on the stage who represents the most important people in this community is Carol Johnson, the president of the Orient Heights County Task Force. That's why we're here today. This complex has been housing to generations of families that have come here. With the help of, when we come together as the city, the state, the federal government, the community, you can certainly see that we're going to be helping transform and move the people of this neighborhood in a way where they live in this place, as I said earlier, that's a great place. When this was first built, it was really groundbreaking housing and it was great at the time. And it's time now that we bring a state-of-the-art 21st century development to East Boston. Public housing is an important part of our story and our history here in the city of Boston. It supports supportive, affordable resources for Boston families. Our developments need to be attractive, healthy, and affordable. That's what we have to do. We have to continue to move forward. The city of Boston's, the housing authority is the oldest authority in the country. And last week at Old Colony Housing Development, we were able to talk about doing more work there and making changes there. Today we're in Orient Heights and tomorrow we're going to be other places. This first phase is 120 units of new housing and upgrades to Orient Heights. We're going to have many multi-room apartments. We're also going to be LEED Silver certified, and every single apartment here will be affordable. We launched the housing plan, Sheila Dillon. I don't know if Sheila's here. I know Devin Quirk's here. I want to thank DND because we launched a new housing plan to create new housing, 53,000 units by the year 2030. But that doesn't mean we stop everything else. That means that we create new housing in the city of Boston, but we also renovate our housing in the city of Boston. And we're able to do a lot of that, and we've been able to continue to move forward. I want to thank Trinity for their investment and their continued investment in the neighborhoods, working with the East Boston CDC here in this community. And also, Trinity does a lot of development around the city of Boston. They're doing a mixed-use development over in Dorchester right now, and they're working. Every time they do a project, they talk about how do we help people that don't have the means to help themselves. So again, I want to thank you, Patrick and Jim, and the whole team over at Trinity for your incredible work. I want to thank Brian Golden from the Boston Planning and Development Agency for making sure the tools that were necessary to make this process happen quickly and efficiently. And I'm going to let you know on a little secret. We are working right now in the city of Boston on selling the Winthrop Square Garage. I've already talked about this. When we talk about this, it's probably the biggest deal the city of Boston's ever seen. It's $150 million. When the deal is closed and we get the first check, it's $101 million. Where that money is going into revitalize Boston Common, going into revitalize Franklin Park, going into complete Old Colony, the last phase of Old Colony, and also $10 million of that money is coming here to East Boston to complete Orient Heights to make sure. The last thing we want is a young child looking out the window saying, "Why come I can't live there and I live here?" So we need to make sure we continue that commitment so we can continue to revitalize the entire Orient Heights development over here. Again, I'm going to end where I began. The most important people in this room today are not the elected officials, are not the state officials, certainly not me, not Billy McGonigal. It's the residents. Yep. We want to let you know that this is what we're doing to make sure you have a great place to live. God bless and happy holidays. Merry Christmas.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Our next speaker has been our partner in this undertaking. Again, a several-year effort. We had to celebrate on this day, but it took several years to get to this point where we had a developer selected, where we had the financing in place, and we would not be here today without the active support of the Undersecretary of DHCD, Crystal Cornegay. Before she comes up to speak, I would like to say a few words about the mayor's financial commitment to this development, the $10 million commitment. That is the single largest commitment of any mayor in the history of the city of Boston to a state-subsidized public housing development. So thank you, Mr. Mayor. And I don't want to put Crystal on the spot, but I'm going to put her on the spot. We've already had a private conversation.
Yeah, yeah.
We are hopeful and optimistic that because of the mayor's commitment, we'll be able to work with the state over the next year or so to firm up funding for phase two. So without any further ado, our friend, our partner, Crystal Cornegay.
I was just saying I left my bag in the car. Someone asked me earlier, was the governor coming? I was like, why do you care as long as he signed the check? Anyway, this is exciting. For those of you who don't know, this is my third event this morning, and at one of the events I was telling people that we have a huge commitment in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts to affordable housing. And one of the signs of that is that we are one of only four states in the country that have its own public housing portfolio. So we have about 45,000 units of public housing that's separate from federal housing, state-aided, of which about 30,000 serves low-income seniors across the Commonwealth. Orient Heights is one of those developments. Most of the portfolio was built in the 50s and 60s, very old, looks like this, most of it. And over time, people at different administrations have had different levels of commitment to investments. I would like to say the Baker administration is deeply committed to making sure that this affordable resource stays affordable and is a 21st century resource, as the mayor described. And Orient Heights is but one of the places that we're making huge investments to do that. And it makes it easier to do that because we have a partner in the Boston Housing Authority and the City of Boston, so who put their money where their mouths are, right? And so it's nice to partner with folks who bring resources to the table. So we're gonna work on this together. One of the first things I did when I took office here was have conversations about this project, and those of us who've done this a million times, you know, one of the things people talk about is like, well, what are you going to do for phase two and phase three? And I'm just like, let's worry about that then. So the mayor just made that easier with the $10 million commitment because he ain't going to make me look small. So congratulations to you all. These deals don't happen, as the mayor described, by themselves. So thank you very much to the BHA and its staff, and to DHCD and their staff. Paul McPartland is here, I see. Roberta Rubin is here, I see. These deals are not small. They can be complicated, and without the staff, those kinds of things don't get done. So thank you for that. Also want to thank our partners at Mass Housing, who we'll hear from later. We had some things that happened at the state in terms of what resources were. We were very committed to making sure that Trinity and the BHA could get this deal closed this year. Mass Housing stepped in. Hopefully they didn't have a hitch. If they did, Patrick will tell me later. to make sure we kept things online, on schedule. So thank you very much, Mass Housing. And then one of the reasons, those of you who know me know, one of the things I miss most about this job is sort of instant sort of feedback around what I do every day. And so there are lots of people who do this kind of work who are into new construction. I'm a big Prez girl. right? Because I believe in folks who work every day and that they should actually get the advantage of having their units upgraded, and they help to keep me honest, right? And so it's like, oh my God, Crystal, like my bathroom, they love a new bathroom, right? Like it's simple, it's easy. It's the small things that make people feel valued, that make people be able to focus on other things. And so very, very excited to be a part of this development. Congratulations to the residents. We may not know how we're going to get it done, but we're going to get it done. So congratulations to everybody, and look forward to phase two.
Thank you, Crystal. Her and her staff at DHCD have been wonderful partners, not only in this effort, but dealing with them with all of the state-assisted public housing throughout the city of Boston. So thank you again, Crystal, for your friendship and your kindness and your generosity to the residents of public housing in Boston. Before I introduce our next speaker, I would like to acknowledge one of the BHA staff people that was critical to pulling this together. Someone who is frequently referred to as the brains of the organization at the BHA, and I can here to attest that's accurate. She is indeed the brains. My dear friend, my deputy administrator, Kate Bennett. Please, a round of applause for Kate Bennett. So our next speaker, this is a collaboration. A mixed finance deal of public-private resources, certainly something that is familiar to us in recent redevelopment efforts, and as we move forward in our redevelopment efforts throughout the Boston Housing Authority, the public-private partnership and developing private investment into public housing is becoming increasingly more important, and in many ways the only way that we can get these major redevelopment deals done. And there will be more to come in that regard in our other public housing developments, particularly our federally subsidized developments. As some of you may know, we're dealing right now with a public-private partnership out in Charlestown, and sometime around the first of the year, we'll be looking at a few other federally subsidized developments to do a public-private partnership. And those kinds of deals would be impossible without the active support of our next partner, the Mass Housing. We are pleased to introduce the Deputy Director. Please, a warm welcome for Karen Kelleher. Karen?
Good morning. I've sat through a lot of these, so I'm going to be brief because I know what it's like to see the parade of officials. I do want to stop, pause to appreciate the commitment on behalf of the Baker administration and Undersecretary Cornegay. The commitment to revitalize state-owned public housing that they've made, and the priority that they've given it, is extraordinary and very, very necessary. So what's happening in this community is transformative here, and there are 45,000 units in the portfolio. So the extraordinary commitment made by the Baker administration, Secretary Cornegay, to this development, I just want to pause and say, please, let's give her a round of applause for what she's already done. It's an amazing privilege to have someone at the helm of DHCD who knows how to get these deals done, and honestly, just how hard they are to do. I also have to pause and appreciate the mayor's commitment to housing and his leadership on both preservation of the existing stock and building new housing. We have a gap between supply and demand, and he recognized that early and has taken a very strong role in leading that effort. And we really appreciate that at Mass Housing. You make our work that much easier. You make it that much easier for us to help people understand why it's important to do the work that we do. So a round of applause for that leadership, please. It's really important. The mayor's team is also incredibly strong and provides such tremendous leadership and partnership. Mass Housing has done more than 260 rental deals with the city of Boston, which include about 30,000 units. You don't get that kind of volume done without a tremendous partnership, and it's just a privilege to work with them every day. turning to this development, the BHA has been an amazing partner. Over the last 15 years, Mass Housing has closed almost 2,000 units of the most physically distressed housing rental units in the city and transform communities with the BHA. That includes Maverick, Franklin Hill, Washington Beach, Old Colony, Lower Mills, Heritage, and now this transaction. And we hope maybe one more if HUD decides to favor us with some more funds. BHA, with Bill's leadership and Kate, is one of the most creative housing authorities in the nation, and it is a pleasure to work with them. We really appreciate the opportunity to work with you on this transaction. Last is Trinity, and some of you know me and know that I spent about 15 years working for a competitor developer doing public housing redevelopment work like this across the country. And some of you may not know, and I can reveal now, the real reason that I changed jobs 3 years ago and came to Mass Housing, it's because we always lost to Trinity in Boston. I had to change jobs to be able to get on Pat's team. So finally, I get to work on a Trinity deal. Trinity is such a pro and really sets the bar high and sets such an ambitious agenda for the communities that they work in. I do know from my past experience how hard it is to put together a deal like this, and this one is unique. It is like a Hope 6, but doesn't bring Hope 6 resources, has state sources and state laws and complexities that all needed to get solved. So the teams working on this deal were vast and mostly not Mass Housing. You have been incredibly fast, I just have to say, in getting to this day. So congratulations and thank you so much for the opportunity that Mass Housing has had to work with you. I would be remiss not to recognize our team, Dan Staring, Jill Lavacchia, Chuck Karimbikas, who I think might be here with us today, Mike Karthus, and Deb Morse, who is here today. I don't know where she is, but she should raise her hand. There she is in the purple jacket, have done tremendous work on this transaction and are so committed. Thank you so much for the opportunity to work with you.
Thank you, Karen. Thank you, thank you, Karen. Before I introduce the next speaker, I too would like to recognize your elected officials. I was reminiscing with Sal before we started here. The first time, Councilor Lamartina, excuse me, first time I met Councilor Lamartina was up on Valor Road about 25 years ago. There was a pesticide spill up there, remember, Sal? And we had to evacuate almost all of Valor Road and put them up in a hotel. And we have reminisced over the years whether or not we'd actually live long enough to see this day. Sal, and we have lived long enough to see this day, so thank you for your support over the years. Again, our next speaker is one of our partners. The wave of the future, and the wave of the present certainly is these public-private partnerships. And again, like our previous speaker, we could not do this without the active support of Michael Cussell and the Public Finance Housing Group. Please, a warm welcome for Michael.
Good morning. My name is Mike Cussell, and I'm the head of City's Public Finance Housing Group. I'm very pleased to be here this morning representing City at this very exciting groundbreaking. The City is dedicated to serving communities and to enabling progress here and around the world. We do this in a wide variety of ways, in part through our municipal securities activities. Our public finance banking team helps states, cities, and public authorities raise capital to build infrastructure, home mortgages, and multifamily housing across the country. City Community Capital, which, by the way, is represented here by Bill Yates, who's in the audience somewhere, and was vital and instrumental in this financing. They're another team in our municipal finance division, and they work full-time on providing lending and investing to finance the construction and rehabilitation of affordable housing. We do so with a particular focus on high-cost areas like Boston. Following a number of other projects we have financed here and in Cambridge in recent years, Orient Heights Phase 1 is the latest commitment that we have made to helping preserve affordable housing units in the region. As you know, this first phase will result in the new construction of 120 affordable units, replacing housing that has outlived its useful life. Five new buildings will contain townhouse units, and one will be a mid-rise apartment building. City is playing two key roles here. First, we're providing a $26.5 million loan to Mass Housing. These funds were in turn lent to Trinity Financial to fund construction. Our second role is as purchaser of low-income housing tax equity, a key source in affordable housing production across the country. Orient Heights is, by all accounts, a complex initiative. It has involved multiple lenders, a ground lease, tax credits, and various ongoing rental subsidies, to name just a few things. Accordingly, it took the efforts of many to reach this closing. I'd like to thank the Department of Housing and Community Development, the Boston Housing Authority, and of course the City of Boston for the dedication and the funding they committed. Mass Housing has provided volume cap and is serving as tax-exempt lender for Orient Heights. City has a long-standing underwriting relationship and a strong relationship with Mass Housing, and we're excited to be working with the issuer in this new capacity on this particular project. We'd also like to take a moment to recognize and thank Trinity Financial. Trinity is one of the top developers of affordable housing in the Northeast. I think that was made manifest in the last comments. This is our first time financing a project with Trinity, and a number of folks at City have let me know that the whole team at Trinity has been an absolute pleasure to work with. My thanks and best wishes go out to the future residents of Orient Heights. I want to thank everybody, and I'd just like to add as a side note that I work on the bond financing side. I very seldom get to see the real effects, the product of what we do. So it's very nice for me to be here today to see what the financing all means when it comes down to bricks and nails and boards and that kind of stuff, and obviously people. Thank you very much, and good luck.
Thank you. Thank you. Our next speaker, also one of our important private partners that has enabled us to finance this critically important program. Please, a warm welcome for Noel Henderson James, the Associate Director of Acquisitions for Raymond James Tax Credit Funds, Inc.
Good morning.
Good morning.
All right. My name is Noel Henderson James, and I'm thrilled to represent Raymond James Tax Credit Funds here this morning. What an auspicious occasion we have. We're excited to be a part of redeveloping this community, bringing new high-quality affordable housing to its residents, and protecting and preserving the affordability of all the public housing here at Orient Heights. All 331 units are going to be rebuilt and preserved, and we can't combat the ongoing affordability crisis in so many of our large cities without preserving what we already have, in addition to building new. Raymond James Tax Credit Funds has invested more than $7 billion in affordable housing across the country since 1986 in 46 states. But this $18 million investment is in this first phase of the redevelopment of Orient Heights is the first investment that we've made in Boston, the first of what I hope will be many more.
Great.
So thank you for the privilege of being up here today, this morning, with so many esteemed guests. Thank you for everyone involved in the long years of planning. I think first planning meeting started in 2008.
Something like that.
So thank you to everyone's involvement that brought us here to this point. In many ways, the hardest part of these first 120 units is done. Now we just have to build them, right? Thank you to the Boston Housing Authority, first and foremost, to Mayor Walsh, the Massachusetts Department of Housing and Community Development, Mass Housing, Citibank, of course, East Boston CDC, the Orient Heights Local Tenant Organization, this is who we're doing it for, and certainly not least Trinity Financial for pulling us all together, and Eva and Patrick for showing us the way. Thank you so much.
Thanks. Our next speaker is no stranger to the East Boston community, or no stranger certainly to the affordable housing community in the entire city of Boston, and someone that I'm delighted that we're able to encourage to become a partner in this redevelopment effort, and someone that is a very dear and old friend of mine. Please, a warm welcome for Al Caldarelli.
One of the benefits of being one of the last speakers is that I don't have to go through the list of all of the folks that have helped to make this development happen. I know that things change, and I've been in East Boston all my life, so I've seen the change. If you went outside, walk to the end, to the first building that's going to be demolished, and look to the building right next to it, it's 26 Crestway Road. 45 years ago, myself, my wife, and my three children lived in that building. And I remember 45, that's why I have that in my age, you know, you start reaching 75 and the like. You look around and people are amazed. Wow, we've been working on this since 2008. I remember meetings of my kitchen 45 years ago talking about what can be done to improve this development. And I remember how discouraged everyone was. Because, you know, when you call something a project, it creates enormous walls from the rest of the community. It's people live in the project. They don't live in East Boston. They don't live on Orient Heights. They live in the project. And at that time, we were trying to work to see, how can we tear down those walls? How can it happen that now people who live here are known as East Boston people, are known as Orient Heights people? And it took a lot of years. And it happens when the commitment of the people who surround us change, our elected officials. They jumped into the battle for this, and that was an enormous change from 45 years ago. We have a mayor who's committed to those kind of ideas. That's what's changed from 45 years ago. We have private developers like Trinity, like the investors that you've heard from, who are willing to come in and make the change. And above all, the Boston Housing Authority and the state agencies who are willing to jump in and make the change. I want to make a little special commendation because I haven't heard their name mentioned, Icon Architects. Mm-hmm. They worked diligently to create a plan that knitted this development into the rest of the community. And I think they were very successful, and I think that we're going to see the results of that when the project is built. So I want to give them a round of applause. Finally, let me say, after 45 years, to see something like this happen is really a capstone on all of the things that I've been involved in over the years. And I look forward to phase two and phase three and whatever else happens in this neighborhood, because we will have a development that's Orient Heights in East Boston and no longer a project. Thank you.
Well said. Thank you, Al. Our next speaker, as the mayor indicated, he stole my line, but he's the mayor, he can do that, is the most important person in the room. With all due respect to our illustrious guests, delighted to introduce for her comments. She's a little nervous. I told her she's going to be wonderful, and she will be. And she will be. She, Carol, is the president of the Orient Heights Local Tenant Organization. And she has been working with us, with DHCD, with the BHA staff, with the local elected officials, with Al Caldarelli and the East Boston Community Development Corporation for many, many, many months now, many, many years now, to see that this day became a reality. So please, a very warm welcome for the most important person in the room, Ms. Carol Johnson.
Good morning.
Good morning.
My name is Carol Johnson. I'm the president of the local tenant organization here at Orient Heights Housing Development. We welcome all in attendance today to this historical historical occasion, which were years in the making, the demolition and rebuilding of Orient Heights Overlook Terrace. As residents of Public Housing Authority, we are thankful for the efforts of our administrator, Mr. Billy McGonigal. And the staff for working and improving the environment in which public housing residents live. With improving living conditions and partnering with agencies to bring much needed services to resident population lends a better quality of life. We know that this could not be done in the absence of others. Thanks to all the funders, to our local and state officials, Trinity Financial, and special thanks to Senator Bonacore and Representative Adrian Madero for the ongoing and continuous support of the LTO. Thank you very much. I'm sorry, I'm nervous. Thank you.
Thank you, Carol. Last speaker, last but certainly not least, is the representative from Trinity Financial, and several speakers have mentioned the outstanding work that they have done developing affordable housing in the city, and they've done a Fitzpatrick and his team and Eva have done a great job at Maverick in this community, at Franklin Hill in the Dorchester community, at Orchard Park or Orchard Gardens, as we call it now. And I was out just last week at Washington Beach with the Secretary of Housing and Urban Development, Julian Castro. They've done a marvelous job on this stuff, and I have every reason to believe, I have every confidence that when we're done here, you will see a beautiful, exquisite development with top shelf architecture, 21st century accommodations for our folks. So please, a warm welcome for the representative from Trinity, Eva Ulrich.
Good morning, everyone. Thanks for being here today. It's an honor to be up here with such a distinguished group of speakers, all of whom have played such a significant role in this project. Trinity is thrilled to be part of such an exciting and transformative project that is the result of a comprehensive community planning process involving the residents, the elected officials, neighborhood groups, and city and statewide organizations. I remember coming out to the site just a couple days before we submitted our RFP response to the BHA and being sort of shocked by the hillside, the topography of the site. You don't really, can't really quite tell on Google Maps just how much the drop is between the top of the site and the bottom. And called Patrick to say I was a little nervous about what we were getting ourselves into potentially. But we're excited to be here today to celebrate the demolition of these 90 distressed units and to break ground on 120 new affordable public housing units designed to be high quality and sustainable. And it's because of the dedication of everyone in this room. These units are just the beginning of a 373 unit master plan, which will transform this development. The project is truly the result of public and private sectors working together to revitalize distressed public housing and to create a better future for those who live here now and to welcome new residents. On behalf of Trinity Financial, I'd like to thank Mayor Walsh for his unwavering support of the project, Governor Baker and his administration for their significant investment in this first phase, and the incredibly committed elected officials, Representative Madero, Senator Bonacore, and City Councilor Wamatina, who have worked to ensure this project and community are a priority for the city and state. We've also had tremendous allies in the Department of Housing and Community Development, who have provided critical project funding. Undersecretary Cornegay and her team worked tirelessly to structure this complicated project. A special thank you to the staff at DHCD, including Roberta Rubin and Paul McPartland, who I think are here today, along many others, and Kate Racer. We also want to thank our friends at Mass Housing under Tim Sullivan and Karen Kelleher's leadership, in particular the efforts of Deb Morris, Dan Staring, Jill Avakia, Carrie Daly, and Michael Karthus, who made this closing this bond transaction very simple and efficient. Many thanks to the city's Department of Neighborhood Development and the Neighborhood Housing Trust under Sheila Dillon's leadership. The dedication of this department staff has been tremendous, particularly the project manager, Christine O'Keefe. And to the many City of Boston departments, including the Boston Planning and Development Agency, Boston Transportation Department, the Department of Public Works, Boston Water and Sewer Commission, ISD, you've all provided a great deal of assistance over the last few years, without which this project would not be possible. Thank you to our friends at City Community Capital, led by Mike Kessler and Bill Yates, who are providing the construction financing for phase one, and to our equity partners at Raymond James, led by Noel Henderson James, who are bringing a significant amount of equity to the project. To our friends at the BHA, we have spent many late nights, early mornings, and even weekends together, working to ensure that the redevelopment plan for Orient Heights is something that everyone can be proud of. Administrator McGonigal, Kate Bennett, Joe Bamberg, Letitia Raymond, Dean Papadimitriou, Wanda, and the whole team at BHA are truly exceptional to work with. We thank the residents of the Orient Heights development and the neighborhood, particularly the local tenant organization led by Carol. The residents have waited patiently through this process for the prospect of improved housing and a more integrated site. Their commitment to this community is a model for neighborhood groups across the country. And to our local development partner, East Boston CDC, we are appreciative of the opportunity to work on another transformative project together. A project as complicated as this one requires the expertise of many real estate professionals, and we are fortunate to have many experienced colleagues on this deal. The visionaries at Icon Architecture, as Al mentioned, they embraced the challenges of designing housing and open space in a steep hillside and found creative design solutions to do so. We thank the professionals at Deb Myers Landscape Architecture, Niche Engineering, Sousa True, Peterson Engineering, and New Ecology, our environmental engineers at McPhail and Vertex, and our consultants at Fort Point and the Novus Group. Thank you to our legal team at Goulston and Storrs and to the many other attorneys who worked on this project. We thank the team at Trinity Management and the relocation team at Housing Opportunities Unlimited, who with the East Boston CDC are committed to minimizing the impact of this redevelopment on the residents here at Orient Heights. We are in good hands turning this phase one site over to Suffolk Construction Company, who will be building these 120 units of housing with a strong commitment to quality construction and local minority women in Section 3 hiring. I would be remiss not to mention the entire team at Trinity Financial under the leadership of Patrick Lee and Jim Keefe, our development department, including Kenan Bigby, Mike Lozano, and Sienna DeSantis, and our design and construction team, including now retired Hank Keating, Enrique Bolito, and Kevin McCarthy, have all worked tirelessly to pull the pieces of this complex project together. We also have the amazing support of others at Trinity, including our general counsel, Jill Hyde, our finance department, led by Rebecca Hemingway, and our asset manager, Jonathan Bramer. And thanks to the BHA and the Trinity team who pulled this great event together. As you can see, there are many people dedicated to the success of this project. Congratulations to all, and we look forward to being here in 2018 to celebrate the opening of these 120 new units.
Thank you, Eva. I would also like to mention, Eva did the Suffolk Construction, and I would like to recognize Eva's proud dad, Mark Ehrlich, from the Carpenters Union. And this construction job will be 100% union. That ends the formal part of today's program. Now, I guess we have this gigantic toy out here, an earth mover or whatever the heck it is, to symbolically demonstrate the demolition. I guess we couldn't actually tear a building down. We were afraid we might hurt someone like me or I don't know. But if you could join us outside, and then you're welcome to come back and have refreshments. Thanks very much for being here today.